Stare into the center of this. Do you see something moving? In less than 20 seconds, you'll find yourself hallucinating. The image is going to start appearing like a rope and will start shaking. These geometric changes, like lines and shapes, are the most common forms of what we call a visual hallucination. I'm here today to tell you why that's happening.
That's right. I'm going to tell you what a hallucination is and why we hallucinate. Hi there, self-helpers, and welcome to Self-Help Yourself. And today we'll be talking about hallucinations. So if you haven't yet, I'd like you to subscribe to my channel, because every week I put out new videos on psychology and how to improve yourself using it. And don't forget to hit the bell notifications icon so that these videos come straight to you. So a hallucination is when you see, hear, touch, taste, or smell something that really isn't there. But it seems very, very real. They mess with your sense of reality. And that's just it. It's not real. And it's not under your control. Oh, so that's why I feel my phone vibrating and it turns out that nobody's been calling me. Ever! Some friends you turned out to be. Interestingly, the most common hallucinations are those that we hear, followed by the ones that we see. Or don't. But why do we hallucinate though? A hallucination can be associated with a number of mental illnesses like schizophrenia, epilepsy, brain tumors, migraines, Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, PTSD, and of course, while you're on drugs. These drugs that cause hallucinations are specifically called hallucinogens. You might have heard of some of them. Cannabis, magic mushrooms, ecstasy, and acid. Their chemical makeup can cause them to bind to different receptors in your brain, which are normally meant for serotonin, creating very vivid and interesting reactions
which make you feel good
and change the way you view reality. But that really is just the way you think things are actually happening, because you're high. Genius. For those of you who haven't seen my other videos, serotonin is responsible for satisfaction. I'll link up one of those videos for you right here. Oh, so that explains why people feel so satisfied after consuming hallucinogenic drugs. Freudians see hallucinations as outward expressions of what someone really wants or wishes. We tend to fall back on a previous mental framework, filling in the gaps in our mind. Cognitive psychologists believe that people just aren't thinking straight. Biological psychologists, on the other hand, seem to be the most clear when it comes to a possible cause for hallucinations. These guys have been stimulating different parts of the brain, and they believe that hallucinations are a result of deficits due to a chemical imbalance and brain damage. They believe that people with hallucinations have trouble filtering out information, specifically the thalamus, which is closely linked with auditory hallucinations. So how do you know for sure whether someone is hallucinating or not? Well, typically you ask them what the nature of their hallucination is. What was it like when it first occurred? When does it typically occur? And how long have they been present? But despite all this research, the real cause behind hallucinations remains a mystery. Feeling euphoric and happy after watching this video? Give it a big old thumbs up and leave me a comment down in the section below if you've hallucinated before or learned something new today. Oh yeah, don't forget to subscribe and stay off synthetic drugs. Watch my other videos if you want to learn how. This is Vikram signing off, guys, and I'll see you in the next session.